Okay. Hopefully it's back. Because what we do is we upload these to YouTube, and it's easier for me to just end the stream and then start it again as opposed to somehow cutting it up in some kind of video editing software. Oh yeah, there we go. Can eat things. And let's do the claw swipe next. I think that'll be pretty cool. So you left click is this, right click can be claw swipe, or what other, whatever other attacks we decide to put in. Mop. Mop. Uh-oh. Run! Oh. The crocodile menace. I don't think I can attack it yet. These guys are hiding. Oh wait, where did they run to? I'm not sure where they ran to. Oh, they're over there. You see them? Off in the distance? They're actively trying to find an area that no one can see them, so they're trying to find somewhere that's out of our line of sight. Which on this map is really just these pieces of geometry. There they go! They're flocking right this way! Where did they go? Oh, they're there. Alright, enough goofing around. Let's get these other animations done. Right, so let's save this. Let's open the new frozen one. Claw swipe. And yeah, let's get started. Working on this animation or the game as a total? We've been working on the game since January of this year. It's kind of February. I started making the first dino model in January, but we actually started working on the game in about February or so. And we've got 10 dinos done so far, though our crowdfunding that's being actively, that's actively going on right now has been, people have been able to, for about $1,000 or so, get whatever dinosaur of their choice into the game. I haven't modeled them quite yet, but I can do them relatively quickly. So yeah. Well, we've got lots of dinos coming in. Alright, swipe. So, with this claw swipe, I figure we kind of need to aim for this area. To go for. But, if I set the keys, it needs to be pretty quick, too. So, I can imagine maybe 50 frames or 60 frames for this one would be enough. Let's go 60. It's easier to scale it back. So 60 frames. Set that. Just got all our keys done. And I can imagine that it would very specifically try and move its head out of the way. Like maybe it would dip down and then actually like arch its back up a bit to try and get that claw attack. Kind of like that. Then bring the head back. Maybe. It's gonna be hard. I can't really think of many things that have this anatomy that also do the attacks, you know? Oh, Unreal, we actually have a crowdfunding also going on our website because unfortunately Indiegogo doesn't accept PayPal. A lot of our community is international and they don't have, you know, an international credit card that would accept, that would be accepted by Indiegogo. Regarding the crowdfunding dinosaurs, there were two types of perks. There was the perk that was the first ones offered. Those ones are being delivered before the game's released. However, the second set of perks that were put up afterwards are... if you look at the perk itself, it says the date that the dino is expected to be delivered. It's generally 1 month after the previous perk. So, for example, if we're aiming for February 2020, then one of the perk dinos is going to be... January, February, I guess it would be March, and then one for April, then one for May, June, July, August, September. Basically, every one perk, we want to see if we can deliver every month or so. But that's really just an estimate. It's so far away from now, it's like a full year from now. I can imagine both my skills at animating and doing the models, and I guess the experience I have in going through the modeling process will get a lot faster as well. So it may be 1 month to get them done, but I can expect easily it might just be even a week and a half or something to get some of these dinos done. But, you know, we'll see how it goes. It's definitely kind of far out from here. Yeah, we're thinking of applying for a grant as well, but we'll have to see how it goes. Because with a grant, we might be able to do things that we can't even imagine. Maybe hire more people, too. That'd be really cool. Maybe what we could do with this... with these claws is kind of like have them go up and then bring them down? Maybe something like that? Ooh, I like that idea for the resting animation. Make it bask like a croc. That'd be pretty cool. Although I wonder if they'd actually do that. Don't crocs do that because their mouth is so large and has such a large surface area that it's able to do that? Oh, I'm not sure. Alright, I'm gonna focus a little bit on just getting this animation done real quick. So let's have him bring it up and then bring it down. Oops. Excuse me. It's gonna be tough. He definitely needs to do it with both hands. Man, this is going to be a bit of a pain. If only I had IK hands, huh? I'm sure I'll figure it out. I wonder if I can... Well, before I start animating these, actually, let me get the body movement down, and then I can have the hands follow through a lot better. It's much too difficult to actually animate the hands and then try and get the body for it, or body moving with it. So let's bring this one. It kind of comes... if we have like a three swipes? Then it can come back around here. You know, I think it'll be swipe to the right, swipe to the left, and then just have that not quite as exaggerated. One, two, three. And then we'll have the body help with that movement. So we'll have a recoil, or whatever the word is. Bring that to the right. One, two. And then three. One, two. I kind of just want to do a double swing, so you got a left hand and then a right hand. But there's going to be lots of different types of attacks, but we just need to get something at least in for the proof of concept. So we'll do like a double slash. You know, you'll be able to go, maybe you want to go one slash, and you can upgrade or down, I should say side grade your attack to just have a really quick swipe. And then you can do the medium style attack, which would be both swipes, and then you can do a heavy style attack, which would be, you know, maybe a flurry of swipes or just one huge attack with both arms or something like that, just so you have the option of different attack styles if you want them. And speaking of which, let's bring this up to the side. So one, two. I think it ends just a little too abruptly. Let's give it 75 frames and then let that fade out. And I think, because I don't actually have a collarbone on these guys, I should have done a collarbone, but I didn't. I'll have to exaggerate the side body movement a bit more, just to get that. Okay. And now we gotta get the head. Keep it kind of steady. See how that looks? I think it'd just be here. Shoot. Bring that over here. Actually, bring all of these over here. That should work. Wait. What is that? Yeah, there we go. Oh, let's put some music on. I have a feeling we'll need to move this down a little so it goes up and brings it down. Then it can bring it back up. Tilt this down just a little. Oh, you know what that? I think that's what we need here. When it comes down here. It just needs to be like more snappy overall. Got the tail movement. Alright, let's do the arms. Oh boy. Hopefully it shouldn't be too bad. So he... needs to bring it open as wide as it can go here. Then right here it needs to be as inwards as it can go. Let's get that motion. Probably further forward though. I think it just needs a little more snap to it. And then the hand. And of course the fingers. Let's give that a sec. I need to get all these. One. Let's just get the other arm going. So he'll kind of... I think this arm in general just needs to be pinned back. Like, you know, just putting it out of the way a bit, but also bringing it out. That. And then right here needs to be the highest point of this arm swing in particular. I might have to do a little bit of white painting fixes around his shoulder. But that'll bring it so right here. Here. So yeah, let's get this arm in. Right here needs to be the pinnacle. Bring that in here. I might pull this arm back just a little so it doesn't get in the way. And just needs a little more. Let's do the fingers now. I try to talk. Sometimes I get a little... I'm really bad at multitasking, but I'll definitely try and explain the process when I can. I feel like something... I think probably if I sped it up in the engine, it would probably look fine. Oops. Let's make it twice the speed. I won't make it twice the speed in the engine, but I think that'll probably... So the hitbox would be kind of like this area. Well, I guess all we can really do is try it and see how it looks. into Unreal. Claw swipe. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much for the subscription. Let's move this into the new Suko. Claw swipe. Oh, shoot. One sec. So it'll look a little bit like this. Wait. Okay, yeah, that. Yeah, I'll speed it up. But yeah, let's fix the jaw here. Let's go to frame one. Bump that down just a bit. And we'll speed it up. Maybe like 1.3% or 1.3 times. Let's do 1.2. And let me do a growl. One sec. Pause the music. I need like a sound. Let's see what we got with medium. One of these. Thank you. Probably something like that, I think. I'll just pitch it down. Put like sound cue. And then we also need the swipe sounds that we've got. Movement. Tail? Do we have the tail swoosh? So yeah, let's do the large swoosh. Oh, no, I think it'd be the medium swoosh. So let's do the medium swoosh. Attach that to the, what's this gonna be? Right here needs to be this on the right hand. And then coming in there. Oh, I see. I have to play that different times. It's got the growl sound, that's fine. This should be like let's see how that looks, or works, I mean. Create a animation montage. Special attack. Oh, I see. Forgot to attach that to a particular bone. Claw swipe. Oh, I see. It just doesn't have any attenuation. Aha. Let's do medium. Oh, no. I guess it would be large if that's growl large. Let's try that again. might change that. What am I using? Bone 3? Let's do spine 1. That might make that feel a little better when you're moving, at least. Might look a little silly when you're running. I mean, I guess it's not too bad. The bite actually works really well because if you're looking down, like a fish, it would probably actually, yeah, it would go right in the water and get it. Yeah, that works. Let's do a falling animation. That doesn't take too long. So let's save that. Could be like 30 frames. I'm really hungry. I'll message. I'm really hungry. This is gonna be a falling animation. Just so you don't do like a T pose when you're in the air. Oh. Ooh, I got food. I asked and I got it. I might, end the stream right now just so I can eat, and then I'll just finish this off stream. It's not a huge deal. When you fall, you'll just play this animation, and then you'll land, and then, you know, you'll be fine, so. Let's put that there and there. Bring that up and out. Okay, that should be okay. I'll tweak the feed a little bit and do stuff, but yeah, thanks so much for watching, guys. I'm gonna end it now so I can eat and, you know, take a break real quick. Might be back later, but most likely we'll be back tomorrow at the very least. Thanks so much for watching.